All right, we are back. It is 3-C. If it looks a little different behind us, it's because we are at our new home, Louisiana Crab Shack in Central Texas Marketplace, and it smells delicious.
Absolutely.
Great place to come watch the games. All these TVs you see, not just the ones behind me, they're everywhere around here, so definitely come down here and check it out. But we are here to talk about some football. It's 3-C. We're each going to pick a high school game, a college game, and a pro game for you to watch this upcoming week. And we're going to start in the high school ranks where last week of the regular season. Mandy, what are you watching?
I'm excited for Shoemaker at Harker Heights. It's our game of the week now. I mean, as we know, in the past, this district has been more so top heavy, but it's been an exciting football season just to see how competitive and how much improved all the teams have gotten this year.
Yeah, definitely. Shoemaker's been a lot of fun to watch this year. It's going to be fun to see what they can do in the playoffs, because we always know, you know, right there early on in the playoffs, you got those DFW schools, so it's going to be fun to watch those teams play. I'm going to go in 4A Division I, pretty much everything sewn up, but the Lampasas Badgers going out to Fredericksburg to take on the Battling Billies and play for a district title. That's one that I'm looking forward to seeing. Fredericksburg, a team that ended my mediocre high school football career, so go get them, Badgers. You go knock out those Battling Billies. That'll be a lot of fun. Ace Whitehead, built for tough player of the week this week. Lampasas offense, you know, since that loss to Lorena, they just feel like they keep getting better and better and better. And boy, I tell you what, the fact that Lorena beat that team and is not going to be in the playoffs, that just tells you what a tough 4A Division II, and what a tough district that was this year. So that's going to be one that I'm looking forward to. Who are you taking in Harker Heights and Shoemaker?
I'm going to take the Knights. I mean, just because, I mean, essentially they have to win to get into the playoffs. Shoemaker's already in the playoffs, so there's not that extra added pressure on them. So I'm going to take the Knights tonight.
Yeah, they've got to get it done. No choice for them. Win. They got to get in, and
exactly.
Then they're going to need some help. So, I'm going to go with Lampasas. I think they're going to get it done tonight and take care of business, go into the playoffs rolling, and really, really excited to see what they can do once they get into the playoffs. So, certainly going to be a lot of fun to watch those. And then, of course, big, big, big weekend of college football.
Oh, it's huge.
And
yeah.
Great place to come watch it here, all these TVs here. What's got your eye on Saturday?
Wildcats in Texas. I mean, you know, Kansas State will be playing at Texas. And, I mean, the Longhorns, you know, it's completely different than what they were expected to do this upcoming season. I mean, Sam Ellinger is coming off a game. He threw a career high of 4 interceptions, which seems unlike him. But there's been some trouble in their secondary, this and that. And as we know, the Wildcats, they're on a 3-game win streak. And they seem like they're a force to be reckoned with in the Big 12. So it'll be an interesting game to see, you know, if the Longhorns can, you know, get things going, you know, on at their, home field and everything.
Yeah.
So definitely excited for that one. What about you?
Yeah, well, certainly going to be looking forward to that one, seeing what happens there. I know, Texas had trouble when Bill Snyder was not the coach. Ron Prince, about the only team he could beat was Texas. So Bill Snyder out now. We'll see what Texas can do, because they really got to, in some sense, save their season, because it really could go down fast. But I'm going to be in Fort Worth with Baylor and TCU. This one is always a fantastic game. It's a rivalry game between these two schools. You know, Coach Rhule and the players downplayed it a lot yesterday, that, oh, it's just another game kind of thing. It's not just another game for these fans. And this is a game Baylor fans like to talk about, that 61-58 win in 2014 here at McLean Stadium. But bottom line is, Baylor hasn't beat TCU since that day. So they've lost 4 straight. They've talked about wanting to beat TCU, not because they're TCU, but because they've lost to them 4 straight times. And this begins a stretch of a season-defining stretch for the Baylor Bears over these next 3 weeks, because you've lost 4 in a row to each TCU, to Oklahoma, and to Texas. The committee ranks you 12th because you got a bad schedule so far. But that schedule is going to pick up very quickly. So I think this will be a big win for the Baylor Bears. And, I think it's going to be a great game. Looking forward to seeing what goes down in Fort Worth on Saturday. Who are you taking in Austin?
I'm taking the Longhorns to turn things around. I mean, for everything they accomplished last year. And I just think that, you know, being back home, maybe a little time to reset, you know, have the reset button. And they've won, you know, they're 1-2 in their last 3 games. So I just think that they're going to bring things around. But it's going to be a close game. I think it's going to be real. Like, it might come down to the last possession.
Yeah,
sure.
I tell you what, that bye week came at a good time for Texas, especially defense. I think old linebacker Brian Jones said they couldn't stop running water right now. So good for them to get a week off. We'll see. Certainly should be a fun one to watch. I am going to take the Baylor Bears. I just think that they have so much to play for down the stretch this season. Max Duggan is hurt. We don't know what the, you know, we don't know what the situation is there. But last year, Mike Collins came in here and he got hurt, and backup or third string quarterback essentially beat the Bears in Waco. And I think they know that. I think Baylor knows that. I think they are determined to end that streak, to not let that happen again. So, yeah, I think the Bears go up to Fort Worth, get take care of business. And then we start looking at that Oklahoma game, getting game day in town,
yeah,
you know, primetime ABC kickoff in 2 weeks. So, yeah, I think Baylor gets to that undefeated still. And we continue to have this debate with the selection committee. So one place where you don't got to worry about the selection committee is the NFL. They decided on the field. So what games are you watching on Sunday?
I am really excited. Well, it's the Monday night. Seattle is going to play the 49ers in San Fran. And basically, as we know, 49ers are undefeated. And I really think that they were a sleeper heading into this season just because Jimmy Garoppolo got hurt last year. But we all know that he was an understudy of Tom Brady. And the 49ers, their run defense has been outstanding. And the Seahawks, you know, I would say the most talented team that they've played up to this point is the Ravens, and they ended up losing to the Ravens. Now the 49ers, they played the Panthers and the Rams, you know, that have, you know, been not, you know, not a garbage team like the Redskins. Sorry, Redskins fans. But yeah, I mean, it's going to be, I think it's going to be the true test. If the 49ers can win, then they are the real deal and could be one of those deep playoff run type of teams. So I'm excited and to see, especially if Russell Wilson can, you know, to see how, you know, how mobile he can be, because we know he can use his legs for sure.
Yeah. It was magic last weekend for sure.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to go another primetime game. I'm going to go Sunday night. It's the big one, the Cowboys taking on the Vikings. Two former Cowboys assistants, Jason Garrett, going up against Mike Zimmer, former Cowboys defensive assistant. And a lot of times Cowboy fans may be wondering, did Jerry pick the right assistant? You know, what is the butterfly effect there? But these two teams, honestly, they're very similar to me. They've had moments where they look great. They look like Super Bowl contenders, but they also have moments where they look terrible. I mean, that Jets loss for the Cowboys, each week that goes by, you wonder what was going on.
Yeah.
And I think the Vikings, you know, they were at a crossroads with Kirk Cousins. And, you know, he stepped it up and played a little bit better as of late. But, you know, both of these teams need this win. This is an NFC game. So you start to look at tiebreakers and seeding and all that kind of stuff. And so I think that it's going to be fascinating to see the Cowboys, if they can come out and not have to play to their competition. If they can come out and play their game. You know, Monday night, that game was terrible. They came out and they played to the level of the Giants, and good teams don't do that. So you want to see the Cowboys come out and take care of business from the outset and win what is a very important Sunday night NFC game. So who are you taking in your game?
Oh, man, this is a tough one. I'm going to go with the 49ers, though. I mean, it's just like the Texas and Wildcats game, I think it's going to come down to maybe the last possession. But I think the 49ers are the real deal. But, yeah, I'm going to take the 49ers on this one.
Yeah, well, I mean, let's not forget the 49ers were a James Conner fumble in the fourth quarter away from losing to the Steelers in week 3. So
yes,
they can be beat because the Steelers weren't very good. Still aren't that good.
Yeah.
But, yeah, that should be fun. I think Russell Wilson is magic. We'll see what happens there.
I have him on one of my fantasy teams, though, actually, too. So I'm a little torn. So hopefully he still puts up some big numbers.
Well, I'm going to go. I think the Cowboys come out. They take care of business. They get it done. I don't think it's necessarily pretty. That's not the Cowboys' MO lately. They can't win a pretty game. But I think that they will come out, take care of business. They are at home. Maybe a little bit of a wake-up call. Maybe a little bit of a rust factor in that game against New York. So I feel like they come out, take care of business on Sunday night, and maybe start to get rolling here, because now we're getting into the point where they're going to start playing a lot of games very quickly.
Yeah.
You got the Thursday night game on Thanksgiving, then you turn it right around and play another Thursday night game the week after. So I think this is a chance for the Cowboys to really start to build up some momentum and start stacking some wins together. So regardless, it's going to be a fun football weekend. Be sure to come down here to Louisiana Crab Shack. Check out the great food. Smells delicious down here. You got food, drinks, soft opening right now, so lots to look forward to. And I would be remiss here at Louisiana Crab Shack. I lived in Baton Rouge for 2 years. If I did not mention one of my three to see, it's a bonus for you. It's LSU and Alabama.
Oh, yeah.
And I feel like this is the year that Joe Burrow and LSU Tigers go into Tuscaloosa, Tua's hobbled a little bit with that ankle, and we're at Louisiana Crab Shack, so I'm going to take the LSU Tigers in a bonus pick for you.
I like that. I like that. You know, with Tua and all that, you know, kind of issue going on, I mean, I would have to side with you as well. Yeah. I think it's going to be a great matchup for sure.
Yeah. Two offenses matching up. This game has been all about defense for the last decade probably, but it's going to be all about offense on Saturday. So a lot of fun. Come out here, watch it all at Louisiana Crab Shack. Lots of great food, lots of great TVs to watch all these games on. We'll be back here again next week. Until then, though, this has been 3 to C. She's Mandy. I'm Matt. We'll talk to you later.